Now on 2K TV. Time to check out the top.
It's the 2K Sports pregame show, brought to you by Kia.
Hello, everybody. Ernie Johnson here with Shaquille O'Neal, Kenny the Jets. And on tap tonight, it's the Cleveland Cavaliers going up against the Houston Rockets. And for Houston, this is their first time facing off this season. Last year, they split the season series at a game apiece. And Shaq, there will be a lot of experience out there on the floor tonight. Two smart veteran rosters going head-to-head. Who gets the advantage in your book?
Well, you know, both teams are going to play fundamental basketball. It's not the game where you throw between your legs behind the back. Simple, fundamental basketball here. I think the team that controls the pace of this game will definitely have the edge.
Well, Shaq, before I answer, how did you control the pace?
Just by putting these elbows in your mouth.
Okay, 4,325 times.
I got it. Oh, you said.
Sports. It's time for NBA action. Our broadcast team tonight, on one side, Greg Anthony. On the other side, Steve Smith. On the sideline, David Aldridge. I'm Kevin Harlan. The crowd here in anticipation of their home team Cavaliers in an interconference battle here at the Quicken Loans Arena. This, of course, their first opportunity to play Houston this season. And not only a 1-1 split series between these two teams last year, guys, but both wins were on the road. So home court advantage wasn't that big an advantage.
And really, this is a team that expects to beat everyone when they step on the floor, but they were only able to split the series last year.
They are not short in confidence, but they can't get too carried away because it could cost them the game.
Here's the starting group for Houston. Patrick Beverley out there with Gordon. Then there's Anderson. Then it's Trevor Ariza. Then it's Nene in at the five spot.
And credit Kyrie, tremendous vision. Finds the open man.
And one of the most resilient players around, Tristan Thompson, hasn't missed a game with injury since 2012.
And for a big man who plays the way he does, battling in the paint, going after every rebound, and also being the muscle for his team, it's impressive he's played this many games.
And the one-hand slam just looks so pretty when it's in his hand and he's the one doing the slam.
Agreed. He is smooth as silk, even on a power finish. Now, here's Ariza. A 14-point game for him in the win against Dallas.
One thing he also did extremely well was rebounding. He really attacked the glass out there.
And the officials whistle a foul on the shot. The bucket's good. He'll go to the line. And that sends Patrick Beverley to the free throw line. It's going to go on Tristan Thompson. So for the Rockets, Clint Capella comes in for Nene. And it's Monty Unis in for Anderson. The Rockets shooting their first free throw attempt on the night. And the Cavs, obviously one of the most talented teams in the NBA. It's taken time for them to learn how to play together, though.
Yeah, you talk about having a big three and guys have never been around each other. And some young guys when you start talking about Kevin Love and Kyrie Irving. Synergy, chemistry, that's all they needed. They have it now.
Here's Love. Adeyunis grabs the miss.
Not a good pick there. If I'm shooting the ball and I'm looking at him, I'm asking, where is the effort? You've got to do a better job of screening.
Gordon outside. Oh, offensive interference. For Cleveland, they've gone 3 of 5 shooting the ball so far. Irving against Beverley. Count that bucket. Irving's got his first 2 points of the night.
The mid-range game, Kyrie can score on every level.
And the official signal the backcourt violation. Not very careful there. We're just about 2 minutes into the first quarter. Outside to the middle, trying to find Thompson. He gets it to him, and a little luck that time, but it drops.
Refining his skill set inside, you see the work Thompson's putting into his game.
Ariza outside, And here is Monte Unis playing Dallas. He was nearly unstoppable. And it goes as the official calls the foul. Count it. He'll shoot one more at the free throw line.
Yeah, he earned that one. I mean, taking the hit and still able to get that one to go down.
Well, Steve, we know some players are notoriously slow starters. It really takes them a while to hit their peak and get to where they want to all season long. How long did it take you to find your groove?
You know, it's different. Sometimes guys are coming off injuries and it takes them a little time. Some guys didn't do anything in offseason,
yeah.
And you can tell right away who those guys are.
We name names. Let's name names.
And then you have some guys that have been traded, and it just takes them a while to fit in with the city and fit in with that team.
And he's good on the three ball.
Only took them a few seconds to answer the three ball with one of their own.
Gave up a little momentum and then grabbed it right back.
Now here's Irving. Not a good performance from him in that loss to Orlando. LeBron can't get it to go. Rockets trail by three. Beverly dishes to Monte Unis. Good D by Love. Cleveland's gone 1-2 from long range in the first quarter. David Aldridge had a chance to catch up with head coach Tyronn Lue. Dave, what do you have to say?
Thanks, Kevin. He told me that when you're playing against a team as good as they are inside, you have to stop the easy looks. He said if they can keep them out of the paint, they'll be in good shape to win. Listen, Kevin, back to you.
All right, thank you, David.
And their offense already in a flow. Some stellar shooting to jump out to this lead.
And Beverly kicks to Gordon. He feeds it to Monte Unis. And the bucket counts, and he's on his way to the free throw line. Try to make it a three-point play. Channing Frye's checked in for Kevin Love. The Rockets shooting their third free throw shot of the game. Now James. 35 points for him last game against Orlando. He kicks it to Frye. Pass to Smith. Again, the Cavaliers score.
And this is where JR can put it on you. Excellent in the catch and shoot.
Rockets trail by five. Ariza outside. Gordon, the pass to Capella. Blanketed by the D. Fights to the rim for the layup.
Pretty much all of their buckets coming from inside the paint now.
Down low. Here's LeBron. Second chance shot, and the layup is up and in. LeBron's got his second bucket tonight.
You gotta love the tenacity of LeBron. He makes an impact on the glass as well.
James against Ariza. The dish to Monte Unis. No good on the three.
And on an open look like that, he's very gifted at making the weak coverage pay.
To the paint. And Thompson kicks to Smith.
J.R. Smith, an all-out gunner. Never saw a shot he didn't like, but you know what? It works for him.
The Cavaliers shooting their first free throws of the evening.
And a season ago, they hit about 75% of their free throws.
Two shots.
First free throw is good.
You know how accurate JR is from three. That's how relatively inaccurate he can be from the line sometimes.
So he makes one of two as the second one misses. Outside Gordon. The feed to Monte Unis. That shot misses. And it's the Cavaliers taking it the other way. And you look at the numbers, Steve. J.R. Smith shoots just as well on contested triples, which is interesting, as he does on wide open ones.
He said he actually prefers contested shots. We're talking about a guy that's confident making tough shots. Sometimes when he's wide open, I think he's just bored taking those.
Now, Fromm. After Monte Unis' three-pointer wouldn't go. Gordon for three. Thompson with the rebound. The Cavaliers leading by six. James outside. No one near Smith as he lets it go. The kick out to Irving. Passes it to Frye. Dishes it to Irving. Back to LeBron. And another miss by Cleveland. Rockets trail by six. They've been looking out of sync offensively.
And they need a bucket in a big way here to regain some confidence.
And it's out of bounds. Last touch by Thompson. Now with this break, let's check out just how the rebounding has been divided up in this game between the front and backcourt for the Cavaliers.
And their bigs are getting the vast majority of those caroms, handling their business on the inside and freeing up the guards to get up the court and look for early offense.
And now the first timeout called here for the Rockets. Steve, you've covered the league and been involved as a player for so long. Just how good are modern coaches? And, you know, an extension of that, who is your pick for being the best coach right now in pro basketball?
Well, I think it's still Greg Popovich. He's done just a fabulous job being able to change styles, bringing in new players, also having guys that were number one option, getting them to buy in, come off the bench sometime, play lesser minutes. And then you have a guy like Steve Kerr, and then also one of my all-time favorites is Doc Rivers. Just a guy who has a great feel for players and people.
The coaches today have so much more at their fingertips in terms of tape and analytics than the coaches of even just 15 and 20 years ago. Is it hard to compare the two groups?
Yeah, it is. I mean, like you said, because there's so much involved now. And then a lot of these coaches are wearing two hats. I mean, they're the president or GM, also coaching. So they're doing totally different jobs than the coaches back in the day.
And they've come out with a take-no-prisoners approach on the glass here tonight, guys.
That's out of bounds to the Cavaliers as Cleveland retains possession. For the Cavaliers, Jefferson's checked in for Tristan Thompson. And it's Amon Shumpert in for Smith. And then for Houston, Ryan Anderson. He's checked in for Ariza. Brewer comes in for Gordon. And it's Pablo Prigioni in for Patrick Beverley. And here's five from the arc. Good, and the assist goes to James. James has got three assists now in this one.
As a defender, you have to stay in Fry's shirt. Otherwise, all too often, this will be the result.
Here's Nene. Another miss, and they've really hit a rough patch here. LeBron dishes to Shumpert. Now, here is Irving. He's guarded closer. And he can't extend the lead to double digits.
It has not been an easy quarter for him offensively, but I like that he's staying aggressive.
Brewer passes to Nene. It's good. It's his second basket. He's shooting two for four.
Beautiful pass that helped set up his teammate perfectly.
Irving kicks to Jefferson. Feeds it to James. Back to Jefferson. On the wing, Irving. And Fry slams it in.
Guy known for style points when it comes to throwing one down, but every once in a while, Kevin.
Greg, why don't we see more dunks like that from him? He certainly got the size for it.
Oh, no question he does. I just think he likes to keep the fans guessing.
Irving dishes to LeBron. Outside Irving. And Shumpert kicks to Jefferson. Cleveland moving the ball around. Shot clock at five from deep. Rebound by Nene.
A team's rebounding is a great measure of its energy, and theirs has been terrific here in the first quarter.
It's stolen by Amon Shumpert. Irving with a clean look. That shot missing, and the Rockets take it the other way. They want to keep it rolling here following the win against Dallas.
They just weren't challenged. I mean, nearly as much as they should have been in that game, at least when they had the ball.
Their offense came fairly easy to them out there. The D wasn't rushing them to do anything, and because of that, they made a lot of smart, calculated decisions that turned into easy points.
No good off the back of the rim.
Obviously, this has been a tough quarter for him, but he's still trying to keep a positive mindset.
Beasley kicks to Anderson. This one for three. No good that time. Great D that time from LeBron. And it's good. Walk through contact. That's the shot. He'll go to the free throw line.
And boy, are they attacking the paint.
And Cleveland making a change here. Anderson's checked in.
I just love the combination of J.R. Smith and Shumpert. Offense, defense, both can score a little bit, both get out and sit out on the defensive end. Just a fantastic combination.
Now now here's Beasley. No scoring yet from him, but that's likely to change. Brewer, the pass to Nene. Left block shot on the way. 2 points, that one goes.
I like that he's attacking this quarter and choosing his shots wisely.
They get a hand on it, and that one goes out of bounds. Last touch by Anderson. And while we can, here's a look at the teams that had the fastest hands in the league last season. The Rockets, number one.
You know, I don't know if the numbers even told the story. I mean, their defense was as good as it gets, often just leaving their opponents completely demoralized.
A nice shot by Anderson.
Timeout.
They keep hammering away at him inside, forcing the ball into the paint.
Timeout called, the Rockets. And so many players in the NBA, Smitty, are passionate about giving back to their communities, lending a helping hand to that next person to help them reach their dreams. And I know it's a cause that's close to your heart. So why is this so important to players like yourself?
Well, it's so important, Kevin, because I think in all walks of life, there's somebody that's helped you. And I had the opportunity to get a chance to help others. And I learned this from my parents, especially my mom. She was the foundation of our family and the community.
And I know one of the big contributions you made is back to your university up in East Lansing, Michigan State, with a huge donation that they are very thankful for.
Yeah, just the synergy I had with Michigan State, also my high school, being able to give back, and especially providing a scholarship for kids to get a chance to have a scholarship to attend Michigan State University.
The Cavaliers shooting their fourth and fifth attempts at the free throw line tonight. And both free throws good for Anderson. Rockets trail by 10. There's the pass to Decker. Kicks it to Hero. And you can count it. He'll go to the line with a chance to make it three.
Yeah, exceptional play there to take the bump and still get it to fall.
And he's got his first chance at the line here. That's good from Hero. Here's LeBron. He's got six. He dishes it to Irving. James outside. Back to Irving. Let's it go. Here's Shumpert.
Now we get a chance to check out LeBron James. Coming off a terrific season. Averaged about 25 points per game. 6 assists and 7 rebounds. And the numbers, while pretty outstanding, I mean, we've now come to expect that from this guy.
And he knocks down the first one.
For a guy as strong and as athletic as Shumpert is, he really doesn't get to the foul line enough, in my opinion.
KJ McDaniels, he's checked in for Corey Brewer. Here's McDaniels, guarded by Shumpert, pass to McDaniels. To the inside, Hero. Anderson with the block. And they get it back. Decker gets the bucket.
And good passing setting up a lot of these buckets right now, Kevin. That's been the key.
A shot's good from LeBron.
He's been on target all night, and that's helped the whole team.
Rockets trail by 8. There's a 4-second difference from the shot clock to the game clock. McDaniels gets to Hero. Now Cleveland moving it up. Anderson with the block. Here's Harrell with 4 seconds on the clock, and that's 2 points on the layup. Harrell's got 5 now.
And that put back about as easy a bucket as you're going to get.
And you can see one team is working hard on the glass and the other not.
And they're scoring pretty well as we conclude the first quarter. Cavaliers lead by 6. It's the NBA on 2K Sports from Quicken Loans Arena. And we got a chance to hear from LeBron James about the...
I go back and I'm able to, read this kind of report.
think you'd have to say the preparation really shows on the court in his play, and rarely does he look surprised out there or caught off guard.
And Kevin, that's really just the mark of a total pro. And I don't think oftentimes the fans appreciate how much goes in terms of preparation. Some guys get it and some guys don't, but he's a perfect example of what proper preparation means in terms of preventing a poor performance.
The second quarter beginning in just a moment. And taking a look at the Cavaliers' performance here, what do you guys see?
Right from the start, they have been able to really own that paint and just dominate the backboard.
They are really fighting for position on every shot release, so they are prepared for the rebound. Fantastic work ethic.
Taking a look at the Rockets, Decker is out there with Anderson. Then there's Harrell, and it's McDaniels at shooting guard. And on our sideline, our reporter, David Aldridge.
Well, Kevin, Kyrie Irving was a virtuoso ball handler when he came into the league. He could penetrate at will and get to the rim. All the injuries over the years, he's made an adjustment to that. He said, I enjoy finishing around the big men, but honestly, I'm trying to stay off the floor. I'm not going to stop trying to get to the basket, but the big men we have, they don't have to do it every single time. We all learned that lesson over the years, Kevin.
Pay the price going in there, don't you, D.A.? Thank you. Now, here is Smith, swiped away. Anderson outside, it's tipped. McDaniels, one up, one down, 2 points with his first shot this game.
They're finding lanes to the hoop now with consistency. 5 buckets in a row from the paint.
Irving kicks to Love. Yes, and it's Irving picking up the assist. And that's 10 points for Love.
When Tyronn Lue took over, the Cavs made sure that he was not an interim coach. They took that tag off, and Tyronn Lue has been a coach in waiting. He's done a nice job getting these guys to move the basketball and play unselfish.
Tristan Thompson, he's checked in for Cleveland. Houston with a big group substitution here. Nene, he's checked in for Harrell. Beasley comes in for Ryan Anderson. Trevor Ariza's checked in for Sam Decker. And it's Patrick Beverley in for Pablo Prigioni. The shot by Nene, no good. And the Cavs front office made clear from the start that they had the utmost confidence in coach Tyronn Lue and his ability to lead the team.
What I love is they revamped his contract, showed the commitment. I think when you see the buy-in he's got from the players and the way he's motivated them, it was a no-brainer.
Smith, no luck.
I am wondering what can he do to get it cranked up. Nothing from long range this quarter after hitting one in the first.
On its way from Beasley for two. And that's going to be a travel. The Rockets making a switch here. Brewer's checked in. The Cavaliers leading by 7. And we're now a little over 2.5 minutes into the second quarter. Here's Love. And he was fouled in the act of shooting. Chance here now for a 3-point play.
A more physical player than he's given credit for. Love finishing through contact, plus going to the line. I hope people don't forget about Kevin Love's elite numbers back in the days. Crazy numbers. 1 year he averaged 26 and 13 rebounds for the Timberwolves.
Here's Ariza. And the 3-ball is good. Ariza's got himself going there. His first points of the game on the deep ball. Outside Irving. Out of hand on it. Beverley dishes to Beasley. He feeds it to Ariza. It's stolen by Jefferson. And it's Love penetrating. And the rebound goes to Nene. Nene's got 6 rebounds here tonight. And for Kevin Love, do you think, Steve, we'll see him get back to those crazy numbers he put up with Minnesota?
No, I don't think so. The reason why he's playing on this team where he has so many other guys that can do everything. Back in Minnesota, he had to do it all. I think for Kevin Love right now, it's about winning and winning and being productive.
The Rockets have gone 3 of 4 at the free throw line tonight.
And looking at last season's numbers, down below 70% as a team from the line.
Cleveland leading by 4. Outside Irving. Thompson, a screen on Beverley. On a another miss by Irving.
Right now, he's trying to find the mark. Unfortunately, he's starting to feel a little bit desperate.
Ariza passes to Beverly. The baseline J. And that one comes up a bit short.
How anyone could give him that much room from his spot is crazy. But the defender got away with it.
Thompson with the bucket.
The vision of Love, the willingness to make the extra pass, just more reasons why he's so dangerous in this offense.
Now, here's Brewer. Back to Beverly. Nice shot from the wing. Beverly's got 5 points so far.
That's just terrific ball movement to get his teammate a wide open shot.
Irving against Beverly. Knocks it loose. Stolen by Beverly. Ariza has the open look. It's good, only a few seconds into the shot clock. Ariza's got 5 points now in the quarter. Cavaliers leading. Irving kicks to Love. There's a whistle. It's going to go on Corey Brewer. That's his first foul. Outside Jefferson. From the high post. Rockets with the rebound. Nene's got 9 rebounds now tonight. On the wing, Brewer. Back to Ariza. He nails it, and we're tied up. He has 7.
And they've had assists now on their last 3 baskets.
Outside Irving. Shoots off the step back, and he overshot that one, missing.
Not a whole lot going down for him at this point. He just can't buy a break.
And they have certainly been looking locked in offensively.
They sure have, staying aggressive and playing under control.
And it's Beasley finishing it off.
And that's how it's done. I mean, find that hole in the D and then go hard to the rack.
Maybe that hole was a little bigger than it should have been.
It looked like a total breakdown to me there. He exploited that hole perfectly and made them pay.
It's a pick by Love. Smith outside. Jefferson with a 3. It's good, the assist that time from Smith. Jefferson's got himself going with the triple, his first basket of the game. For the Cleveland Cavaliers, their last game a loss to Orlando.
And listen, you have to take advantage of the freebies. And on that night, they did not. And that is why they just could not recover.
When the defense breaks down, you have to take advantage of them. And because they blew their chances, they have only themselves to blame.
Steve, now that it's all said and done, when you look back in your career, do you have one of those single moments that stand out as your favorite?
Yeah, I think my favorite for me is probably on draft night. But then I think the moment that he retired. So everything in between, and the good and the bad. A lot of people point to the championships and all-star and the gold medals. But I think the relationships, the ups and downs, the injuries, just everything that shapes you as a young man.
One of the, going with the saying that the journey is the reward.
It's totally right, Kevin. I mean, that journey, a lot of people don't get a chance to have that journey. So you want to appreciate even the things that didn't go so well.
Great perspective. The Cavaliers have gone 6 of 8 from the free throw line tonight.
The one thing about LeBron James, he's had a huge impact on the basketball court, but also off the court, always taking a stand on a lot of social issues.
Knocks down the 3 ball.
His skill set really spaces out the floor, given how lights out he is from outside.
Outside Irving. From deep. Rockets with the rebound. Gordon kicks to Capella and stolen by Fry. Shumpert dishes to Irving. Back to Shumpert. Lets it go from deep. Rockets with the rebound. Anunis has got 3 rebounds so far in the game. In the corner, it's Gordon. And another 3 for Houston.
That's just an awesome assist. Really paced the ball in that ideal spot.
Beverly against Irving. Let's a floater go, and he lays it up and in.
Hitting only 1 of 5 this quarter. He's in a little bit of a slump, but it looks like he's trying to shoot his way out of it.
Gordon gets to Mantiunas. In the corner, it's Brewer. Outside, Gordon. Capella inside, guarded by Fry. Out of bounds, Cleveland will take possession. And a moment here to look at where the shots have been coming from.
And the three-point game stands out as a major sore spot. It just has not been falling for him. I think at this point you start to get away from that shot. Try to engage in other parts of the offense. You don't want to hurt your team if that long ball isn't there.
The Cavaliers trailing. James kicks to Irving. Shumpert in the corner. And Capella sends it back. Pass to Brewer. LeBron grabs the miss. LeBron's got his fourth rebound in this one. Outside Irving. Off target at the rim.
See, when you're going into the teeth of the defense, you have to go harder. Soft lay-in won't cut it.
Gordon against Shumpert. Gordon, the pass to Mantiunas. Drills it from outside. Mantiunas has got 14 points.
Oh, great ball movement there.
The Cavaliers trail by four. They've been struggling here on offense.
Yeah, a bit of a dry spell for sure.
And here's LeBron outside. Cleveland gets it back. Irving for three, sinks the triple. He has seven.
Something that's kept this game close is the fact that the rebound stats for both teams are almost identical.
Capella kicks to Gordon. Houston moving it around. And another three for Houston.
That's a dozen straight points coming off the triple.
Well, Cleveland shooting 43% from the floor. The dish to LeBron. Good, and the assist goes to Irving. Irving's got his seventh assist of the game with that last one.
Seizing every opportunity to score. LeBron outworking, out-hustling people inside.
Capella kicks to Gordon. It's stolen by Iman Shumpert. Irving with the ball. 7 points in the game. To the inside. It's stolen by Capella. On the wing, Gordon. Guarded by Shumpert. Gordon kicks to Beverly. It's rebounded by Cleveland.
What I like there, fantastic defensive rotation. Just suffocated him at the point of attack.
Love can't hit.
Yeah, and a dangerous trend here as they're starting to live and die with outside jump.
Oh, no, he may have gotten injured right there. He's in a lot of pain.
Yeah, and as many times as you see it, you know, you never get used to seeing a player have to come out with injury.
I hate it. Getting a chance to see him walk off the court, not good.
Houston, a whole new five on the floor. Anderson, he's checked in for Kevin Love. Houston in the lead. Here's Brigioni. Wyatt so far offensively, searching for his first points of the game. For three, Decker gets the bucket.
Defensively, they just look out of sync, not closing out on the threes in time.
Now here's LeBron, not a lot of room. He kicks it to Fry. Deflects the pass, stolen by McDaniels. And now the fast break, Anderson with the ball. Over in the corner, Decker. And a miss there on the triple. The Cavaliers trail by five. Now, here's Fry. He has five. And on the way from Irving for three. Yes, it's James picking up the assist. James has got his fourth assist with that last one here tonight. Prigioni kicks to McDaniel. The feed now to Prigioni for three. It's hauled in by Fry.
And you could tell he thought that triple was going to fall.
Passes it to LeBron. All sorts of time. Headshot off.
To me, that's just a loss of focus. He was wide open from one of his favorite spots.
Over in the corner, Decker. We've got a 9-second difference between the shot clock and the game clock. And as it goes out of bounds, Houston able to keep the ball here. Here's McDaniels. This is to Harrell. And two free throws coming up as he misses that one. Drawing the whistle on a lot of contact there. And it's going to go on Amon Shumpert. The Rockets have had 7 opportunities at the free throw line and made good on 5 of them. That free throw, no good. He hits the second from the line. There's 18 seconds left in the second quarter. Now here's James. He's guarded closer. Feeds it to Irving. From deep, 3-point range. Got it!
Yes, indeed.
He got it! What a shot!
Concentration. 3 points at the buzzer. How in the world did he get that one to go?
So the clock runs out with the score tied going into halftime. And now let's catch up with David Aldridge, who's standing by from the sideline. All right, Dave.
Thanks, Kevin. Here with Coach Teron Liu. Coach, what is the focus going to be in the second half?
Just play the right way. Move the ball, share the ball, get stops, and get out and run the transition.
And now, the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
And hello again. We have amped up home crowd joining us for our halftime report. Ernie Johnson, we've got a pretty even game underway at Quicken Loans Arena. Kenny, your thoughts. How are the Cavaliers playing?
Well, so far, they've taken care of their business here at home. It's something you might expect, but it's not a given. We'll see if they can keep that up in the second half.
And Shaq, let's get your input on the Rockets.
I was surprised at some of the recklessness. They were scattered, sloppy ball handling, just too many turnovers. It gets back to fundamentals. Forget the highlight reel pass. Make the effective one. Simple bounce pass. John Wooden taught us that in the 40s, 30s, 50s, whenever he was coaching. Just play under control. Simple ball, dude.
That, sadly, wraps up.
Welcome back to Cleveland, Ohio, home of the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. My wife and I toured that recently. It is worth the price of admission. Here we go now, the start of the third quarter, welcoming you back in a closely contested first half so far. You look at Monte Unis today, he's been every place.
He created a lot of quality shots for himself in that first half, and he knew when to pass it up when the double team came.
Just awesome on-court awareness, knowing when to take it to the hole as well as dish it out. That's why he is such a crucial member to this team.
Smith and LeBron filling out the wings. Love and Thompson, the hard rebounding post pair, and it's Irving in at the point. So that's who's on the floor for the Cavaliers. There's Brigioni looking for his first basket still in this one. And there's the pass to Gordon. Nene down low. It's up against Thompson. And Thompson sends it back.
Great timing by Tristan Thompson on that block. That's his forte.
Ball stolen. Oh, and a fast break for the Rockets. Brigioni, that's good. Gioni's got the first points of the second half up on the board for the Rockets.
And the defense to start that play was terrific. I love the fact that they attacked early in the shot clock. Yeah, these defenders had better start closing down on shooting.
And here's Gordon following the three-pointer by Kyrie Irving. Outside Gordon. Kicks it to Ariza. 6 on the shot clock. Here's Nene. From down in the low post, it goes. Nene's got 11 points. Guys, close one here. No team getting a huge advantage.
Yeah, tooth and nail fight so far, guys. These sides match up really well.
Love, good, and the assist goes to Irving. improving. He's got assist number 8 now on the night.
Good ball handler for a power forward. Love attacking on the drive.
And Kyrie Irving, one of the most talented scorers, certainly, Smitty, in the NBA, but he feels the pressure, I think, to try to tighten the screws in his game defensively.
You don't get many nights off defensively at the point guard position in today's NBA. That position is very deep. No excuses, though. To be great, you've got to get it done at both ends.
Cavaliers have gone 2 of 3 from the field to start the second half. It's tipped. It's stolen by Ariza. He dishes it to Anderson. That 3 off the mark.
And he's really having all sorts of problems with his jumper right now.
And if you're the defense, you probably should sag off him right now because he's not knocking down anything.
They get it back. Here's James. And a foul called on the shot. Got him on the way up that time, so he'll shoot 2 right here.
The poise of LeBron. Little pump fake. Gets the defender in the air. That's all she wrote. LeBron James, one of those players, when you watch him play, you just wait for his body to break down, but it has not. Reason why, he's done a nice job of taking care of himself. He's always been in tip-top shape.
And after a 2014-15 season that saw LeBron miss 13 games, including a voluntary 2-week hiatus about the midway point of the year, last season, Stevie said he felt much better.
And that's great. You talk about a guy, you talk about that place basically all year round when you start talking about his commitments in the summertime and still be able to play at a high level. The NBA season is a grind. He's getting through it.
The shot's good from Smith.
Deadly from beyond the arc. JR cannot be left alone.
Gets trailed by 3. Ruggioni dishes to Ariza. Takes the 3. And again, it's the Rockets from deep.
Only took them a few seconds to answer the 3 ball with one of their own.
Gave up a little momentum and then grabbed it right back.
Now here's LeBron. He's got 15. 2 points. That one goes. And that's now 6 points for Tristan Thompson.
He delivered that pass right on the spot to his teammate who was on the move.
Out of bounds, Cleveland takes possession. Courtesy of the 2K leaderboard, here's a peek at the league's top scorers from a season ago. 5th on the list, LeBron James.
And looking back, his points per game really underscored the fact that he never took a game off. I mean, one special performance after another all season long.
Irving kicks to James. Smith outside. It's up a 3. Again, the miss by Smith.
Something seems off with him tonight. Maybe it's his rhythm or his timing. Fortunately, his teammates are playing well enough to keep them ahead.
And it's out of bounds. Last touch by Ariza.
And taking a look here at the numbers for Kyrie Irving. A very nice season for him last year. He was around 19 points per game last year. 4 assists and 3 rebounds. Backup point guard, always an important position, and he fills that role beautifully.
Cavaliers making a switch here. Jefferson's checked in. Clint Capella, he's checked in for the Rockets. Beasley comes in for Trevor Ariza. Another miss by Cleveland. The Rockets trail. Gordon with it. Now Smith defending. Pass to Prigioni. Beasley kicks to Gordon. Here's Capella. Chance there to take the lead. Missing. Smith the pass to Irving. Outside Jefferson. Once again off the mark by Cleveland.
A 3-point marksman. He couldn't have asked for a better look. Sometimes it just doesn't go down.
Ruggioni dishes to Gordon. Off target from 3-point range. For Cleveland, they've gone 4 of 9 from the floor so far in the third. Smith for 3. Good, and the assist goes to Irving. Irving's got his 9th assist in the game now. Rockets trailed by 5. Beasley right side. Prigioni for 3. Thompson with the rebound. Thompson's got double-digit rebounds now in the game. Smith kicks to Jefferson. Lets it go with the 3. Again, the miss by Smith.
And the great shooters know when they've got enough opening to go for the 3. I didn't think it was a bad choice on that possession.
Houston moving the ball around. Stolen by Thompson. Pulls it up. Smith missing again.
He had all the room he needed to get the shot off. Just couldn't find the bottom of the net.
Grigioni, the pass to Capella. And here's Gordon from outside. No good on that one. So Cleveland will take it the other way. They've led by as much as 10. Here's Irving. Lets it go from the baseline and nails it. Irving's got 5 points now in the quarter.
Absolutely fearless, Kyrie. You have to do more than just get a hand in his face.
Okay, time now for an injury report. Now let's check in with David Aldridge to see how Patrick Beverley's doing. David.
Hey, Kevin, I spoke with the head athletic trainer for the Rockets. Unfortunately, he's saying it appears to be a broken ankle, which, if it's true, would be devastating. The season is still very young, but that is bad news to get at any point of the year. We'll see how the team responds without him, Kevin.
David, thanks for the great update. We appreciate it, and we really hope for the best, as always.
And he's a tough guy. My guess is he'll be back before we know it, and better than ever.
And I'm sure his teammates want to see him come back very, very soon.
Kicks it out to Gordon. Tries a three. Thompson with the rebound. Thompson's got rebound number 12 now. Tenacity on the glass. Now, here is Irving. D right on him. Beasley against Jefferson. Lock at six. Smith for three. And the rebound goes to the Rockets. It's stolen by Jefferson. Back to Smith. He feeds it to Irving. To the left side wing. And here's Love for three. Good, and the assist goes to Irving. And that's now 18 points for Love.
And really, as the three-pointers keep dropping, you get the sense that the frustration is mounting for the defense. It only took them a few seconds to answer the three ball with one of their own.
Gave up a little momentum and then grabbed it right back.
Irving kicks to Love. And foul called as he misses. He'll go to the line and shoot two. That one's on
Jared Gordon.
You know, Kevin Love in Minnesota, he was the franchise player. He was the go-to guy, but he never made it to the playoffs. When he came to Cleveland, he came for one reason, to win it all.
Looking at who's out there now for the Cavaliers. Chris Anderson has checked in for Thompson. And it's Amon Shumpert in for Irving. And then for Houston, Anderson comes in for Clint Capella. And Corey Brewer's subbed in for Eric Gordon. Now, here's Nene. 13 points in the game. On the wing, Brewer. No good. Shumpert with some nice D. And when Love came to Cleveland to play with LeBron, he knew he'd have to sacrifice touches, Steve, just like Chris Bosh had to in Miami.
Yeah, you have to balance fitting in with showing what you can do. It's not easy, but the fact that Kevin Love is trying shows you what he's all about.
And the Cavaliers making a change here. Fry's checked in. And then for Houston, Sam Decker's checked in for Beasley. And it's KJ McDaniels in for Brewer.
Impeccable from the line since halftime.
Rockets trail by 10. Grigioni dishes to Decker. Pass to Nene. It's rebounded by Cleveland. Anderson's got his third rebound tonight. And Jefferson wide open. He shoots. Offensive rebound. Fry. The basket drops, and he gets fouled on the shot. One free throw coming his way.
And with the success they've had rebounding the basketball, they're right where you'd expect him to be, firmly in the driver's seat.
And this is his first trip to the line tonight.
And when you shoot 86 from the line like he did last season, you usually cash in on those opportunities.
Now, here's Decker. He has six. Here's Nene. And so he draws the foul on the shot, a trip to the line to shoot two.
I mean, even from over here, you can see that one pretty clearly.
And this is his second trip to the line tonight. So for the Rockets. Monty Unis has checked in for Sam Decker. Gordon comes in for McDaniels. And it's Brewer in for Pablo Prigioni. And here are the Cavaliers. They're on an 18-7 run. Shumpert passes to Anderson. There's the pick. Smith for three. The shot will not fall. And the Rockets take it the other way. And Brewer kicks to Monte Yunus. Back to Brewer. From the arc. Shot is good, and the Cavaliers' lead cut down now to just 8 on the basket for Monte Yunus.
He has really made an impact from beyond today. That's another triple.
Just think where they'd be without all the work he's done from the three-point line today.
Now, here's Fry. He's got 8. And Channing Frye wasn't a three-point shooter coming out of Arizona. Smitty, he sure is now.
It wasn't until his fifth season in the league and his third team in Phoenix that he started to focus on the three ball. And yes, he's a stretch 5 or stretch 4. He can shoot the basketball.
The Rockets making a switch here. Harrell, he's checked in for Nene. Decker comes in for Monte Yunus. McDaniels, he's checked in for Eric Gordon. And it's Pablo Prigioni in for Brewer. Jefferson dishes to Shumpert, stolen by McDaniels. And here's Anderson. Out to the right wing. Launches a 3. Good on that shot. And with that, the Cavalier lead is cut to just 7 points in the basket from Decker. And Shumpert kicks to Jefferson. Cleveland moving the ball around. This one for 3. Shumpert, no good. Rockets trail by 7. The dish to Anderson. Over to the wing. Harrell, the pass to Anderson. So he gets the whistle. Contact on the way up, and 2 shots coming up. First trip to the line for him here.
And looking back last season, how about 87% from the line? So that's obviously nothing to sneeze at.
They aren't making anything at the line today. This is a team that struggles at the line.
LeBron, he's checked in for the Cavaliers. And a switch here also for Houston. Gordon's checked in.
And what an advantage. You really feel like you can always trust him when he's at the line.
And LeBron with the basket, the assist by Jefferson. 17 points for LeBron.
He's got some serious momentum going right now. He's been great all day. Even last game, he was on fire.
You know what? He doesn't get worn down coming off a big game. It just builds him up even more.
And so here's Cleveland following the score by Houston. Outside Jefferson. He kicks it to LeBron. There's the screen. 6 to shoot. From downtown, Richard Jefferson, and that's good. Jefferson's got 6 points.
You never want to give him an open look from outside because he will flat out burn you from there.
Decker dishes to Anderson. From the arc, drops in the tray. Anderson's got 8 points in the quarter.
Back at you. I mean, they immediately get those 3 points back.
Hey, let's see if this turns into a long-range shootout.
Jefferson against Gordon. Now Jefferson. And it's Eric Gordon with the foul. That's his 3rd foul so far. Bonus situation in effect, so we'll head to the free throw line for 2.
And not the guy you want to send to the line. He has been automatic.
And he can't hit the 2nd. From deep. Misses. Shots continuing to fall as we conclude the 3rd quarter. Both teams putting up points. Cavaliers ahead. They lead by 6. And do not go away as we'll be back in just a few moments with the start of our 4th quarter coming up next. Got a great game on our hands as we welcome you back. The 4th quarter of action getting started. The Cavaliers leading by 6. So on the floor for Houston. Ariza and Monte Yunus are your small and power forwards. Gordon out there with Brewer, and it's Capella in at the center position. Irving misses. The Rockets shooting 47%, pretty solid. Ariza gets to Maniunas. Lets it go from deep. Scores the bucket. He's 7 for 11 and continues to look good.
And they're getting their points now almost exclusively from the triple. 4 of their last 5 makes are from beyond the arc.
And stolen by Gordon. Here we go with Gordon. Nobody back. Here's Ariza. That one, no good. Great D that time from Irving. And here's James outside. He watches it go through the hoop for his 8th make. Now 8 for 14.
We talk about LeBron's amazing versatility. That time showing confidence from deep.
Here's Capella. And the layup's good off the glass.
That's a brain freeze right there from the entire defense. Now is not the time to lose your focus.
Protecting the rim has to be their number one priority here in crunch time. They need to recognize that immediately.
Rockets trail by 6. And it's Ariza in the corner. 3-pointer. And another 3 for Houston.
He is starting to build up a little confidence. Hit just 1 3 in the entire first half, but he has hit 2 more since then.
Outside jumper. Tried to answer back, but that 3 is off the mark. Rockets have gone 3 of 4 in field goal attempts since getting things started here in the 4th. Maniunas kicks to Capella. Good D by Thompson.
Now that's terrific defense at the rim. Got right in his path.
That will be in his head the next time he comes down the lane. He'll have thoughts about that one.
Love check in for Channing Frye. And there's the feed to Shumpert. Cleveland moving it around. Pass to Irving. Fires the 3. Here's Thompson. And that one is good with the extra effort on the glass.
The unbelievable effort. Thompson, a dedicated warrior on the offensive glass.
Gordon, the pass to Ariza. Out left to the wing. Beyond the arc. Maniunas, no luck. The Cavaliers leading by 5. Here's Shumpert. Up again. It's rebounded by Houston. Capella's got his 7th rebound of the game with that last one. Ariza kicks to Maniunas. On the wing, Gordon. Back to Maniunas. On deep. And it's LeBron James with the rebound. Cleveland's gone into a funk from downtown in the 4th. Only 1 of their 5 three-pointers has found the bottom of the bucket. The Cavaliers making a switch here. Smith has checked in. Ryan Anderson, he's checked in for Houston. Here's Smith. Irving dishes to LeBron. It's stolen by Capella. Out of bounds, Rockets ball as Houston keeps possession. Sam Decker's checked in for Houston. Rockets trail by 5. Ariza outside. Decker with it, working on Thompson. Decker gets the bucket. And we're about 3.5 minutes into the 4th quarter. Outside Irving. Accurate with a jumper from the elbow. Irving's got 9 points now in just the 2nd half.
From that in-between range, they've been the much better team.
Gordon kicks to Decker. Back to Gordon. Dishes it to Decker. The 8-footer. Thompson with the rebound. Thompson's got his 16th rebound on the night. In the corner, it's James. Feeds to Smith. The pass to Irving. Basket good. And it's a 7-point Cavalier lead.
Filling it up at will. Kyrie's arsenal on full display.
Yeah, real nice shot selection there. I guess he's working on his buzzer beater form.
Or maybe he just loves playing defense.
Now here's Love. They get it back. Thompson. The shot by Irving. That's in. Coming off the assist from Thompson. That's now 26 points for Kyrie Irving.
His teammates recognize that he has the hot hand going. That's why they get him the ball every chance they get.
Now a timeout called by Houston. And with the long ball taken over, Smitty, we've heard some different suggestions, creating a four-point line or widening the court to give a little more space for the corner. Any of those ideas work for you?
No, not at all.
You don't like any of that, do you? No.
Four-point play, widening the lane. What? I mean, easy.
Yeah.
That's enough. We're good right now.
Yeah. And we've got an update here, so let's catch up with David Aldridge.
Kevin, I was able to listen in on what Mike D'Antoni was talking about with his team. They have been getting killed from long range tonight, and he said we can't lose track of their shooters. We're overpacking the lane, and we're leaving them wide open. Guys, we'll see if they can make the adjustment.
All right, thank you, David. Here's Irving, following the basket by Sam Decker. Love with another miss.
The thing about setting screens, you have to be willing to sacrifice your body. It can't be half-hearted.
Decker can't hit. The Cavaliers leading by seven. Inside. It's good, and he drew contact on the shot, so he will go to the line. A three-point play chance here. Nene, he's checked in for Houston. Monta Yunus comes in for Ryan Anderson.
One thing about Thompson, he's made improvements to his body and his game each and every year.
Rockets trail by 10. They really want to find that igniter here.
Yeah, their offense has ground to a standstill.
Takes it from 10. Misses off the left iron.
They have been board dominant in this game. That's definitely been a factor in cracking this huge lead.
In this second half, the defense have been baiting him to shoot the three, and we're seeing why.
And the basket by Gordon.
How about the way he's able to angle his body to shield the big fella off and still get the finish?
Well, he has to be able to use angles. He has to be a great finisher in tight spaces and to be able to throw his little body into the big guys.
James, that's a two-pointer. It's hauled in by Gordon.
Almost no chance of that shot going in.
On that play, you gotta trust your teammates. Instead of forcing that one, just pass it.
Now, here's Nene. No good on that one. Good D by Thompson. To the middle, here's Love. Good, and the assist goes to James. Love's got 9 points now in just the second half.
The body control of Love after he takes the hit. Strong finish.
Here's Monta Yunus. A three-pointer off the mark.
And you know, it's almost as if he wore himself out with that performance in the last quarter. He hasn't had nearly the same kind of energy in this one. And certainly, they are not hesitating, letting it fly from deep here in the second half.
And here is Monta Yunus after LeBron James hitting the three.
He clearly wants to try and close this game out strong, but your deep range isn't there. You just can't keep forcing it.
Love and a foul on the shot. He'll go to the stripe for two.
Kyrie Irving, former number one overall draft pick, rookie of the year, multiple All-Star games, gold medalist. He has his own signature shoe, and yet I think he still has room to even get better.
Houston making some changes. Decker's check in for Gordon. And it's Pablo Prigioni in for Corey Brewer. Decker with it. Kicks to Prigioni to stop the run. Sinks the three-pointer. And Kyrie Irving says he'd like to take on more of a leadership role that can be tricky sometimes when you're a guy playing with a superstar like LeBron James.
Yes, because he's obviously one of those leaders that he's been in place as a leader, one of the best players. But I think Kyrie Irving is trying to learn from LeBron and take more of a leadership role. You can do that. You can have two leaders on a team.
Thompson outside. Back to Irving. First free throw is good.
I'll tell you this, if Kyrie can just stay healthy, the sky's the limit on what he can accomplish in this league.
Here's Prigioni. Now, here's Decker. Ariza outside.
Decker passes to Nene. Basket made. That gives him 7 field goals in 13 tries.
High basketball IQ right there. Saw his teammate had the advantage, so he got him the rock and let him go to work.
And on the way from Irving for 3, that shot is off. And it's Houston the other way. Following this game, they hit the road. They'll take on the Knicks in New York. That game will be game 2 of 5 out on the road.
And at a time, they really need him to shoot well. The exact opposite is what's happening.
Love outside. Back to Irving. He dishes it to Smith. There's the pick. Love against Mody Unis. Shot clock at 5. Cleveland needs to get a shot off here. Adeyunas grabs the miss. Adeyunas has got 4 rebounds in this game. Ariza outside. Houston moving it around. Frigioni kicks to Nene. Here's Decker, and Decker shoves it in.
And he gives that rim a good tug on the way down.
Well, that's how you drive your point home right there. Cleveland leading by 8. Outside Irving. And it's going to be a 3-second call. Rockets trail by 8. Over to the left wing. Here's Bonnie buries it from 3-point range. Bonnie Unis has got 23. Guys, we've seen a lot of turnovers in this one.
Yeah, focus, focus, focus. Just make the simple play.
Now here's LeBron. Here's Love. Bounces high off the rim and drops. Love's got 6 in the quarter.
This is the thing about Kevin Love. He can go off on you. The talent level is there.
Now a timeout called by Houston. Kyrie Irving really making a difference here.
He's been a terror from beyond the arc. If you're guarding him, you have to stay in his shirt or he'll bury you. Let's see if the defense can come up with ways to at least run him off his spots.
Catching up on the changes for Houston. Anderson comes in for Monty Unis. And Gordon subbed in for Decker. The Cavaliers leading by 7. LeBron outside. The screen from Thompson. James dishes to Irving. And LeBron gets it to go with the assist by Irving. 25 points in the game.
And making it look completely effortless. LeBron using his immense talent to score at will.
Anderson passes to Nene. Marked down low that time, and he got the 3-second call. And for the Cavaliers, they're shooting pretty well at 46% from the floor. Irving kicks to LeBron. Kicks it out to Love. No good from outside.
Surprising. He usually puts the dagger in your heart. That wide open from 3.
Pass to Prigioni. Latrey. Kept alive. Here's Nene. And finally they hit one.
He is simply one of the best offensive rebounders in the league. He never quits on the glass.
Now here is Irving. D right on him. He feeds it to James. Soft on the front of the rim and drops.
At a time when everyone's obsessed with threes and dunks, LeBron showing off a strong in-between game.
Now a timeout called by Houston. They're behind by 9. 44 seconds left in the fourth quarter. And it's a completely new group on the floor for the Cavaliers. And then for Houston, Monty Unis comes in for Anderson, and it's McDaniels in for Gordon. Here's Monty Unis. Houston gets it back. Prigioni dishes to Monty Unis. Here's Ariza. Good on the triple.
Just dialed in from the 3-point line in this fourth quarter.
I mean, these are daggers. When you start hitting threes in the fourth quarter, it really deflates the other team.
Nails it! And now they trail by just 4.
The D realized their mistake just a little too late, and he made them pay for it.
27 seconds left in the fourth quarter. 2 points here might be all the cushion they need.
You would think so. This game is theirs for the taking.
There's 14 seconds left in the fourth. All by himself. Connects!
And that's how you take the steal and turn it into a transition opportunity.
Great defense resulting to immediate points. Head up, and as soon as he gets it, the ball is gone.
Here's Felder. So it's a narrow win for the Cavaliers pulling it out. That was a fun night of basketball and fabulous finish as they continued to wait out until the very last moment to seal.
And there are so many times when you see these tight games won at home, that advantage of having that crowd behind you oftentimes is the ultimate X factor.
A chance now to send it over to David Aldridge, standing by courtside. David.
Kevin, thanks very much. Kyrie, slow start for you offensively, but you got it going on later and carried your team.
My teammates just do a great job continuing to encourage me, just telling me keep shooting, don't worry about it. And the law of averages, it just balances itself out. But more importantly, I'm just thankful that we got this win.
Great effort from you tonight, Kyrie. Thanks very much. Back to you, Kevin.
All right, David, great job. Thanks so much. And that'll do it, folks. For Greg Anthony, Steve Smith, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan saying thank you for watching. We'll see you next time. Now we'll send it up to the award-winning Ernie Johnson, who is standing by for the post-game show.
The 2K Sports post-game show.
Welcome back, friends and neighbors. Ernie Johnson along with Shaquille O'Neal and Kenny Smith as we... Kyrie Irving. He took on the scoring load in the second quarter practically all by himself. Time and time again, his aggressiveness paid huge dividends. What are your thoughts, Kenny, on his game tonight?
This was one of those what I call microwave games for Kyrie Irving. He got hot, and he stayed hot. How can you ask anyone to do anything more from the point guard position? Inside, outside, creating for his teammates, Kyrie had it going on tonight.
Well, this win was really, really needed, and he went out and he got it for them. They lost two in a row coming in, and dropping the third straight would have been very, very rough. But he took it upon himself, took it right to the ship, as he always does. Great performance and a great time to deliver.
And that'll wrap things up. Thank you for joining us. For Shaquille O'Neal, for Kenny the Jet Smith, for Kevin Harlan, wherever he might be, and for the rest of the 2K Sports crew, the best in the business. This is Ernie Johnson. Good night, everyone.